Artificial intelligence is an interesting concept that I think has tremendous value as we go forward. I believe that there's over 28,000 different journals that exist, and of all of those, everyone is trying to get published, and only about 10% of them get read, and people can't read things in other languages, so that there needs to be some way to integrate the information that will make a difference to the particular question or the particular problem that a clinician or a researcher is trying to solve. So I think that the artificial intelligence can help integrate those kinds of data and findings from different locations and different kinds of publications and give you some sense of what are the issues that are, need to be considered in that particular instance. And it can then further tell you the and give you some ranking of the quality of the information, quality measured by, was it, you know, a huge randomized clinical study or was it a one case by a clinician, all of which have importance, but they have different levels and different time frames and different kinds of information that can be all integrated. Having said all of that, I think that artificial intelligence is very good at, each system within artificial intelligence is very good at one thing. So, for instance, a computer program with AI has been listening to Bach and can create a Baroque masterpiece. So other artificial intelligence systems have been able to play Go or learn the rules of Go and beat the masters. So that's really very exciting, but the one that plays Go can't compose Bach. And one of the nuances that I think is really important and shouldn't be overlooked is that the clinician and their experience, or the researcher, and the clinician and their experience and their expertise need to be complemented by the artificial intelligence, and it can make them more effective, it can make them smarter in many respects, but it cannot replace what's going on. It's a great adjunct, but it isn't an instead of.